Aaron. It's Dr. Delphin giving you a call again. Haven't heard from you in quite some time, and would really love to talk. If you can just give me a call back, that'd be great. Talk to you then. Hope you have a great week.
This is where I sit.
Oh!
This is my seat.
Well, I mean, you know this isn't high school, right? You can sit wherever you want. It's not assigned seating. Like, literally, like, all these seats, you can sit wherever you want.
Oh.
Yeah. So, I mean, if you want, there's a seat right there if you want to go sit in it. Yeah, yeah, right past that door.
Can I just, I just have some papers.
There's papers over there too, and all the computers are linked, so you can reprint them out if you need to.
Okay.
Okay.
Cool.
You know what's better over there? In the drawer, the Starburst.
I let life's heavy weight lay on me, trap me. I'm unable to make choices I need to make when I need to make them. I've simply pushed them out, pretending they don't exist. Throw faith and love out the window. What's the point? I feel like I'm drowning, gasping for air.
Without getting our hands dirty.
Look, kid, all you gotta do is hire someone to do the job for you. That's it. Not you, not someone connected to the family, it sure as hell not me. Capisce?
Yeah, that's good thinking, Frank. Real good thinking.
I get lost, you're scuffing up my view.
I don't... I don't know who it is I'm supposed to... you know what? This is actually the wrong place. I'm sorry. I'll just go.
Hey, kid, get back over here. Who are you here to see? I know you ain't the pizza boy because I don't see any pizza in your hand. So quit wasting my time.
I don't know who I'm supposed to see. I'm here for some dirty work.
This isn't a gay brothel, kid. Sorry.
No. That's not why I'm here. I can't get my hands dirty.
Just a sec. Hey, boss. I got somebody here that needs some work. All right.
Glory of my life. What a happy ending. If we've been at it like rabbits, now we acting friendly. Then someone has to say something that we back offended. Halfway in the up and acting apprehensive. Now every sentence and a half is on some hateful shit. I'm an asshole. You're an ungrateful bitch. And let our friends tell me we don't need each other. If they ever had their way, we'd never see each other. Yet you and I know this love is mutual. A lot of abnormalities, but not unusual. It's beautiful when two adults can come together.
Such an unceremonious way. But you see, this all has to be kept completely under the radar. You understand? But I do apologize.
No worries.
Now, while you were out, I had the chance to read up on you a little bit. You know, I can normally pinpoint what a client wants just from how they dress, all right? Most certainly from what dirt I can dig up on them. So my question to you is, why are you here? And I couldn't find anything about you, anything that would help me in helping you. Darren, what do you need from me? Drugs? A couple of hookers? Larceny? You need someone killed?
Yes.
Man, which one?
Look, man, I will put a bullet through your skull if you don't close that hole in your face.
All right.
What is it you need from me, Darren? All right, Tony, will you get that application from my friend Darren, please? Here, fill this out. I'll need specific details about where this person will be at all times. Be very thorough. Oh, Darren, please tell me you brought cash today.
Oh, yes.
James, why do you insist on talking to the clients, man? Do you want to be me? Do you want to be sitting in this seat?
No.
Hey, man. Just chill.
All right.
How was your weekend, dog?
Hey, my weekend was pretty good, man. Took the wife and the kids up to Coney Island, even though the beaches were filthy, man. We still managed to have a good time, man. I saved a lot of money, man.
Coney Island's such a landmark, man. We all done? Guys, can I have the room alone with Darren, please?
Sure.
What is this, some type of joke?
No. What?
Look, there's no turning back from this. Once this hit is out, it's out. No cancellations, no refunds, game over. My guy's a cold-blooded killer. He'll stop at nothing to kill you.
Understand.
All right. Well, to make this as clean as possible, don't stop doing what you normally do. Go about your life as usual, and we'll do the rest. just understand how unusual this is for me.
Yeah. Me too.
Let him out, Tony.
Mrs. Jones, if you don't know how to operate your cable by now, then I guess there's no hope for you.
Yo, what's up, Eric?
Oh, what's up, Justin?
Ah, man, not much. Just gotta go holler at Darren real quick.
You mean Derek?
Wait, is it Derek?
I think so. But hey, between me and you, it's been a real bag of tools today.
Wow, that's not good. It's about to get worse.
Like, we're supposed to tell you to turn it on, then turn it back off, and then it never works. Okay, listen, hey, listen, the big boss man's talking to me, I gotta go. No, hey, no, I can't help, just be quiet. Shut.
Whoa. Derek, did you just hang up on that customer?
My name is actually Darren.
Hey.
Darren, did you just hang up on that customer?
Yeah. You said you needed to talk.
Yeah, but after you got finished with the customer, we talked about this, bro.
I'm so sorry, Justin. It will not happen again.
All right, listen. I just got off the phone with the customer. They say you've been harassing him.
No, that's some bullshit.
Whoa. None of that language in here, man. Listen, Darren, I think you're a good guy. You know, I like you. I like you like a yellow starburst. You know, I'd rather have pink. I'd rather have red. When you get to the yellow, it's just disappointing. I gotta let you go, bro.
So you're firing me?
Yeah, but we're still cool, me and you.
I'm just so happy, because you know why?
Yeah.
I never liked you. At all. God, I didn't like you.
I like you, Derek.
I hate you.
He doesn't mean that. He doesn't mean it. We're good friends outside of work. Yeah.
Joey. You want to do like a game this weekend or something?
Yeah.
Oh, that's not going to happen, bro. Nah, I don't think so. This guy. Hey, yo, Derek. Why are you taking those kids' drawings, bro? It's not even your desk! Come on!
I take it you got fired, or did you quit?
Both. Yeah.
Well, mystery man, I'm sad we won't be having lunch together anymore. But I guess I'll see you later. Bye.
Again. Not sure if you changed your number. Really need to talk, Darren. So if this is the right number, please give me a call back. That'd be wonderful. All right. Thanks so much.
y'all gonna get us some shoes? I mean, you know, I got a long line here.
Oh, so, I'm sorry. I didn't see anybody in line.
What are you doing here?
I was gonna ask you the same question.
Shouldn't you be job hunting?
Oh, yeah, well, I kind of gave a break on the job hunt for a while.
Mom, I got one. Good job, honey.
Yo, how long is this convo gonna last? I mean, give me a rough timeline.
I'm sorry, I'm gonna get a pair of shoes and bowl the game.
Do you mind if we bowl with you? Unless you're meeting someone?
No, I
must warn you, I am basically a pro at bowling.
You're lying. I ain't never seen you.
Do you want to bowl with mommy's friend? He's shy.
Piss to get off the pot, man.
Oh, how much for three pairs of shoes in the game?
Oh, you don't have to pay for us.
It's fine, I don't want to.
It's $45.96.
Seriously, you did not have to do that, but thank you. I don't actually know your name.
It's Darren.
Okay, well, I'm Emily. It's nice to officially meet you, Mystery Man. We've worked together for like what?
About a year or so.
Yeah.
What shoe sizes?
I guess I need a 5 in boys and 7 in women's.
Oh, 10 and a half for me.
Well, someone needs to use the restroom really bad. I guess I'll meet you at the lanes.
Okay, yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
7 out of 5. And you'll be on lane 7. And she seems to get her number for me.
Okay. Not that kind of guy.
No. Okay, well, I can accept that. Well, thanks for hanging out with us today, Derek.
Oh.
Are we leaving yet, Mama?
Oh, yeah, baby, in just a minute. You want to go sit down for a second? You should take my number.
Okay.
Yep. There you go. Well, don't be a stranger, Mystery Man. I'll see you later.
Bye, bud.
love you. We're all here for you.
I think your mom and dad would want you to have this.
Medic 5-4.
We've got an approximately 50-year-old male showing signs incompatible with life. We're calling for authorization for time of death.
Medic 5-4 is going to be transporting one mid-50s female patient to Crown Point Signal 3. Be advised, CPR is in progress.
Hunting? They found you in a hunting field with a bullet wound.
Where am I?
Crown Point Hospital.
Thank you.
I feel like. I feel like my life is moving in circles.
Oh.